So, good afternoon, Mr. Keshe. Today we are actually exceedingly fortunate to have with us Mr. Mehran Keshe, a nuclear engineer, and he's with the Keshe Foundation for the development of new technology. And Mr. Keshe, we understand you're situated in Brescia, northern Italy.
Yes, that's correct.
This is an absolutely astounding time to be alive. There's a lot of excitement and anticipation about what is to come. And we understand that this week marks the launch of the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. Could you tell us a little bit about the Spaceship Institute and how it came to be, and what are its aims for the near future?
A Spaceship Institute, which is part of the Keshe Foundation, is the pinnacle work of what we have done for years after writing a number of books and papers, and for so many years just spreading the knowledge through lectures and presentations. So what the Keshe Foundation decided to do some time ago was to literally teach the technology to people, very much like a university base. The Spaceship Institute was the brainchild of sharing knowledge with people who in numbers can share the knowledge further with more people, with the difference that up to now, usually the teaching has been one-to-one or into group of people in the small sessions like 3-4 hours lectures or workshops. But with the opening of the Spaceship Institute, we have undertaken to teach a number of people over 2-3 years. But teach the whole aspects of the technology in being motion, energy, food, materials, health, interaction, building of systems, and primarily the ethos of the Keshe Foundation, that the technology and the knowledge has to be given freely to world population, which means a lot of call it open sourcing. Open sourcing has no meaning if you cannot teach it to be done the correct way with the mental attitude and interaction in the society.
Mr. Keshe, when did you initiate the concept of the Spaceship Institute?
So we set up something like 6 months ago to start this institute to teach a large number of people. We teach a core of between 8 to 10 people thoroughly with all the aspects of the technology. And then in a matter of a few months, we bring another group. We teach again another 10 or 15 or 20 people as new knowledge seekers. And then these people become the teachers for the whole institute to teach in masses from September of next year.
Mr. Keshe, what type of progress have you seen so far?
So what the progress has been that literally from the first week, theoretical, practical, and teaching will come together worldwide. Man's knowledge will be increased rapidly.
This sounds like the ultimate university.
It is the ultimate university. We will change a lot of things which has been put wrong, right, but in a way we kept the population with us. We carry the people to make the changes. And part of the carrying people is to educate people the right way. Not the way which has been done up to now, not by peer review, not by putting things in the wrong place, in the wrong way, and then 20 years later somebody might read it and put it somewhere else.
It must be going so well, because we heard a quote back from someone that the first day was great beyond our expectations.
It'll be like that every day.
Yay!
Mr. Keshe, who are attending this inaugural session of the Spaceship Institute?
We have a lady from Japan. We have two people from, one person from Belgium. We have another second person from Belgium, but he's been raised in Congo. We have a gentleman from Spain. We have Slovenia. We have Czech. And we have an Armenian from United States.
And are these are these scientists, researchers, specialists?
The whole concept, the whole the work of the foundation is we teach normal people that they can understand and they can transfer the knowledge to majority of the people. This group I chose very, very carefully.
Yes.
We received a lot of application from doctors, professors, scientists, space scientists, pilots, helicopter pilots from Russian organizations and in governmental systems, all sorts of people applied for it, for this position, the 8-10 positions. We have a dentist who is on with us now. We have biologists. They all have degrees. They've all been through university, so they understand the concept. At the same time, because they have read the books and they have built their own reactors, some of them, they have a good grasp of what is on the table and what needs to be done. So that has made life much easier. So all the works we've done over 2-3 years has birth fruit. Now we see how easy we have welcomed people from 6-7 different nationalities around the same table, and we learn and we teach each other. But you have to understand, it's the beginning of a new way of teaching.
Oh, that's part of this whole process. It's this big exponential leap. This is the giant leap.
We hope so. Because if they don't break our leg, we should jump.
Thank you so much. We will
be
in touch.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you. Bye-bye.